support the Sunshine State. Text STORM to 51555 and help the Salvation Army's Hurricane Ian relief efforts today. Watch 1226 on your side, wherever you go. From the station that's on your side, this is News 12, NBC 26 at 11.
Good evening. Tonight at 11, early voting starts back up again tomorrow for week two. Election officials are telling us they're seeing hundreds, even thousands of people walking through the polling site doors and casting their votes. Every single day of early voting here in Richmond County has beat the midterm numbers back from 2018. Yesterday was our slowest day at just over 900, and that was still individually more than any other 2018 early voting day. Our Sydney Hood reports on how officials are getting ready for week two. And Sydney, a huge turnout last week. What's the outlook looking like moving forward?
It doesn't look like those numbers and lines stretching out the door are slowing down anytime soon. As we approach the final countdown for the big day, election officials say planning how your vote is an important step in making sure your vote counts. Planning your vote.
Early birds are hitting the ballot boxes, and the numbers speak for themselves.
With a midterm, you usually don't see the same type this heavy of a turnout. It's a welcome surprise, I should say.
Richmond County welcomed almost 6,000 voters in the first week of early voting, a statewide trend which Gabriel Sterling says is exceeding the expectations.
Record turnout. We're just blowing doors, really.
Before any more doors are blown away, you'll want to make sure you have a plan.
Know what's on the ballot before you come, because it is a big ballot. There are four questions on the ballot, so the more you can do to prepare yourself before you come, the easier it is when you come.
One way to prepare yourself is with a sample ballot.
And so when you get to the voting machine, you just look at your sample ballot, copy off what you've already done at home, and you should be in and out very quickly.
In and out is how officials want things to run.
If you want to protect your vote, make sure your voice is heard. Just put some thought into it. I mean, it's so important. People fought and died to give people the right to do this. The least we can do is put a little effort in our computer or our phone to figure out where I need to go to cast my ballot.
Officials suggest you know your early voting location ahead of time, and we have all the locations open tomorrow and this week. Right here, Richmond County early voting can be done at the municipal building, and starting on Wednesday, voters can go to the Henry Bigham Community Center and the Robert Howard Community Center. And then right over here in Columbia County, early voting will continue inside the G3 building at the Board of Elections office and at the former Oochie Creek Library. Again, starting tomorrow and Tuesday, Richmond County early voting will be at the municipal building from 8:30 to 5 p.m. Columbia County will be at the G3 building at the Board of Elections and the former Oochie Creek Library from 8 to 5 p.m. Richmond County, starting on Wednesday, they will open up two additional locations for early voting. You can go to the Robert Howard and the Henry Bigham Community Center or the Municipal Center from 8:30 to 5 p.m. Over in Columbia County, they will continue to keep those two buildings open from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Friday.
Thank you for that vital information, Sydney Hood, for an important election coming up. And now we're tossing things over to a live look.
Middle 70s, and then we are talking about those temperatures right back towards the low 70s by the weekend.
Alrighty, thanks for the heads up, Mikhail. One three-year-old New Yorker is already obsessed with the subway system, and he plans to ride every line available. Ida Siegel has the story.
Three-year-old Mark Lee is a New Yorker through and through. If he's going somewhere, it's on the subway. And he's obsessed.
He just loves it so much, and that's all you need. Like, just go on one subway and as happy as ever.
He likes the colors, he likes the numbers, and over time he just memorizes every number and sign.
Mark knows every line, and he wants to ride them all. His parents are trying to make that happen, so we invited them to take a ride with us. But before we got on the train, he got a surprise from the MTA.
I have the power to make you a conductor for the day, of which I'm going to make you, so that is your official conductor diploma.
Transit President Richard Davey crowned him conductor for the day and gave us the green light to board Mark's favorite train, the B.
Should we get on this train?
Yeah.
Yeah, we should? All right, let's go.
With that, we headed down into the Bryant Park Station. fellow conductor.
Ride my train? Okay, let's go.
Then we piled on to a rush hour uptown B train.
Okay, let's hold on together.
Ooh. Wow.
What number is this? 4, Channel 4, rides the B. Mark has been riding the subway a whole 6 months. Is that right?
6 months?
Yeah, and he's got 3 subway lines left to try out.
So we have to take the J and the 5 and the M.
So
which
3
I'm
left.
Kind of saving for his birthday.
Mark's parents try to make every subway ride an adventure. They mostly go on the weekends and make sure to check out cool New York City attractions along the way. But for Mark, it's the journey, not the destination.
I think people see us and then they're like, okay, like, let us sit and give some fist pumps.
Hey, it's done.
It was time to say goodbye, but no tears were shed because Mark knows, as all New Yorkers do, there will always be another train coming. And the next stop might be even better than the last.
Alrighty, future travel advisory person there. Awesome job, Mark. Now, Dwayne Johnson set a new milestone with his latest movie. And how did Black Adam fare at the box office? Rick Damigalia has the countdown.
Lyle Crocodile crawled back 2 spots this week. Back on the flavor. Check his $5 meal deal. You've earned it.
Alrighty, a bit of self-love before we end. News 12 just won 6 awards from the Georgia Association of Broadcasters Conference. But most importantly, Best Weather Team, which includes the Weekend Crew's very own Mikhail Hanna-Harding. Congratulations, Mikhail. I'm going to toss it over to you for our final weather from the very best here in Georgia.
I can feel the energy, man. Appreciate it. I'll take a bow for all my fellow teammates on the first layer with the team. It's not just an award for me, but all of us. So appreciate you guys trusting us with the forecast every day. And speaking of the forecast, I'll go ahead and bring up the 7-day real quick. We are talking about those temperatures, a lot warmer and milder. So lots of upper 70s for the week ahead. Some slight chances for rainfall, but looking mostly dry.